Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to show you how to load two or more CSV files with different number of columns into same table. Let's see files before loading data into tables. Assume that here in this file, there are 10 columns are there. This is the headers and this is the one row. Headers here C1, C2, C3, these are the column names, and here we have a one row and another file which is having only 8 columns: C1, C2, C3, C4, C5, C6, C7, C8, like that. And here we have one row. Third file, here we have only 7 columns. Please note that here whatever, even we have a different columns, but the order of columns in the file is same. So here we are missing from this file C8, C9, C10. Here we have missing C9, C10. So whatever that missing columns should be not from the left side. Okay, it's end of the file. We can even miss, there is no problem. How we are going to load, we will see. But however, the order of columns should be same. This is the very, very, very important. If order of the columns is not same, then we may get the errors during the loading because of column types mismatch. If you have a column type same, then we don't get error, but the values will be swapping instead of actual column to another column. That's why here make sure that the order of columns are always same, even though few columns are missed. So here I am using the DemoDB database, and here I am going to create a table with 10 columns. Table is the test underscore C underscore 10 underscore 8, and please note that here I am here I am defining all the columns with where care. We can define specific to data type, okay, data types as per your requirement. So I am going to create a table test underscore C underscore 10 underscore 8 successfully created, and please note that here I added two more columns, metadata columns, file name and file row number, because I am going to load the three files. So to differentiate which row, I mean, you know, which row come from which file, for that matter, I have included these two columns over here. So now I am going to create a file format. File of type is the CSV, and skip header is equal to 1, because in each file we are going to receive the header information. That's why here I am creating file format with header. So yeah, my CSV file was successfully created. Now I'm going to create a internal stage. You can use the external stage or whatever it may be. Here I'm using the internal stage. Create stage, create or replace my stage. Stage name, file format is equal to my CSV file format. Now let me list the file. Just now we created, so 0 files. Now what I'm going to do to upload the files or copy the files into internal stage, we have to use the Snow SQL from our client or any other connectors. So here this is the command to connect to Snow SQL, and I already connected. Now just I am going to use these three files, and also set in the context info. The files have been uploaded. Now let me see the files. Sorry, 1 minute. Let me uncomment. Yeah, here 3 files are there in our internal stage. So now what I am going to do here, this is the copy command. By using the copy command here, you know, all columns I have mentioned, and from select all the column names, even though here up to 10, t dot dollar 10, t is the alias name, and these are the two extra metadata columns to get the file name and row number from stage T. And pattern here I am using the test star because all file names started with the test, and while uploading I didn't mention anything option, zip option, so gzip happened. So on error equal to skip file. We'll see, this is the command to copy data into Snowflake table from different files, even different with different columns, total number of columns. Here if you see, copy command executed successfully, all the three files loaded. If you see status for each file loaded, and the number of loaded is the one, and error limit, but error seen here if you see 00, that means all rows, I mean each file we have one row, so three rows have been loaded into this table. So now if you look at the data here, what I'm going to show you here, this is the 10 means all columns are there, file name, and 8 means 8 columns, and last 2 columns we didn't provide any data, last 3 columns we didn't. So for these columns we got the null values. Please note that these we got the null values, and whatever that columns exactly have 10 columns, we have seen that values. This is how we are going to load the data, even columns, number of columns are different from the files. So here what this one, if you see that $6, $7, this is the trick we are going to use. This one we have to use this one. So even if you do it, if you mention here any number, like you know $20, like that, so we don't get any error. It will just returns the, if that position, the 10th position, this is the 10th position from the file, 10th column, if 10th column is not there, just simply it will return the null. That is the you know how we are going to handle. So now what I am going to do, suppose if you don't want to load the data when columns are mismatched, in that case what we are going to do, you have to create a CSV file format with error on column count mismatch is equal to 2 parameter. This is one of the file format parameter. So while loading data by using the copy command, when you use this file format, before loading the file, before loading the data into table from the files, it will check whether number of columns between your table and file is matched, then only it will load, otherwise it will throw an error. Let's see that one also here. Okay, file format, my CSV file format loaded. Here I am going to use the another table because I don't want to use the other two metadata columns, file row number and file name. For that I am creating the another table, test underscore c underscore 10, the table created. Now I am simply using the copy command, copy into table just now created from my stage. On error is called skip file. We'll see here. See, three files processed, and out of three files, one file loaded and two other two files got failed because of columns mismatch. If you see first error, what is that error? Number of columns in file 8 doesn't match in the corresponding table 10. Here that in table we have 10 columns, but file we have 8 only, so that's why we got the error. Another for error, the number of columns in the file 7 does not match that the corresponding table 10. Use the file format option, error underscore on underscore column underscore count mismatch is equal to false. If you want to load this one, you have to use the false. So this is the process how you are going to load the data into table, even not match the number of columns, or if you want to match the columns, then you have to use the parameter. So this is purely based on your requirement. If you want to error out when you have a mismatch, then use the this parameter. If you don't want to error out and you want to load the data even though number of columns are mismatched from your between your table and files, you can load without using this. However, please remember that the order of columns if change, then we are going to get the data type mismatch errors. Here I created the table with all the var char, that's why we never get the like error, even though columns mismatch, columns order mismatch. Please follow this approach. If there is no column orders mismatch from one file to another file, then only you can use this option. If column numbers are different and columns order also different, then probably we may need to follow different approach. I will try to make another video in that case. Yeah, that's all from this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Click bell icon for more notifications. Like it and share it to your friends. Thank you once again.